Since 1919, the American Legion Auxiliary has been about connections. Connection between members who share a common passion, connection with the military and our veterans, and of course, our connection with the Legion family. This past year was not only built on these connections, but it truly served to strengthen them. I had the privilege of experiencing these connections firsthand. I also had the opportunity to build some personal connections that have forever changed my life. In the past few years, the American Legion Auxiliary has worked strategically to form important connections with Honor Flight, Race Across America, and other organizations working to honor and support our military, veterans, and their families. My husband Daryl and I trained and served as guardians on a September Honor Flight, and it was an experience I will never forget. My veteran, Susan, was one of the strongest, toughest, fastest people I have ever had the privilege of knowing. People say I'm fast, but wow, Susan was tough to keep up with. She was unstoppable. In fact, Susan just did another Lone Eagle honor flight, only this time she was serving as their medic. My first connection with the Race Across America's escort to Arlington was during my year as National Vice President, and it was life-changing. This year was no exception, although it did involve a bit more travel to get there. The morning of December 7th, I was with the Legion family leaders in Hawaii for Pearl Harbor Day. By that evening, I was on my way to the airport for an overnight cross-country flight to Maine, where I arrived just in time for the 5 a.m. sunrise service. After the service, Daryl, Chappie, a military chaplain, and Rico, a retired colonel, and I were loaded into our car, and the wreath caravan was on its way to Arlington. One of our stops was at a school where students each presented on the life of a Gold Star family veteran. Speaking the veterans' names out loud was a symbol of honor and remembrance, a promise that they would never be forgotten. At Arlington, 70,000 volunteers did the same. They read the grave marker, laid wreaths, and said the veteran's name out loud and promised to never forget. In just over 2 hours, every single grave had a wreath, and the view from the Tomb of the Unknown was something none of us will ever forget. Organizations like Honor Flight and Race Across America serve as the ALA's connection to like-minded organizations in the community. And together, we are better at serving our military, veterans, and their families. This was also a year for deep connections with our Legion family. The American Legion National Commander Daniel C. Hafer, Sons of the American Legion National Commander Don J.R. Hall Jr., and I were all proud to work alongside each other throughout this administrative year. But most of all, we were proud of Be the One, our mission to prevent veteran and military suicide. Be the One has resonated with our members. At every event we attended, there was at least one member who shared their connection with veteran and military suicide. I visited a unit in a small town in the Midwest, and as I spoke about Be the One, I could tell it was affecting members who had gathered to listen. When I was finished, a veteran came to the mic and said, "Those that she's talking about, those veterans struggling with suicidal thoughts, I was one of those people. Be the One has given me permission to talk about it, permission to be okay, permission to know I'm not alone." Later, his wife came up to me and said that that was the first time he had ever publicly shared his story. That night, I knew another important connection had been made. Be the One is not an easy mission, but the important ones never are. There have been plenty of tears shed and stories without happy endings, but we continue to fight. We fight to destigmatize mental health issues. We fight to let people know it's okay to not be okay. We fight when others cannot fight for themselves, and we fight for more happy endings. Ask any past national president, and they will tell you the question they got asked the most was, "Are you tired yet?" And of course, I understand why. Traveling to 44 departments, countless units, dozens of VAs and veterans homes, national cemeteries, Fisher houses, USOs, six presidential libraries, fall, midwinter, and spring conferences, department conventions, ALA Girl State programs, the Pentagon, and the 9/11 Museum might sound tiring, but for me, every single event was another opportunity to make a connection. Serving as your national president has been a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to hear members' stories and to hold the hands that we serve. And I will never tire of those interactions. They kept me energized. At the National Veterans Creative Arts Festival in Denver, it was a heartwarming experience to witness the amazing talent of our veterans, the healing power of the arts, connections made, and the love for the auxiliary was so heartwarming to witness. It was great to reconnect with old friends and make new ones with the veterans. I'm pretty sure I gained some new Facebook friends. As a national leader, I've been to DC several times, but attending ALA Girls Nation gave me the opportunity to experience DC through the eyes of these incredible young people. It was inspiring to watch our country's youth debate bills and learn so much from one another. Our future is in good hands. The American Legion Auxiliary wouldn't exist without members. So thank you for becoming a member or renewing your membership once again. We worked really hard and stopped the membership slide for 2023. I'm hopeful that our momentum continues through the close of 2024. I'm so proud of the progress we made. You matter, and together we can make a difference for our veterans, military, and their families. Mission training was a great opportunity for members to connect and learn about Be the One, the impact of membership, ALA branding, and much more. These one-day conferences inspired members to continue working ALA programs in interactive and fun environments. Thank you for all the members who attended a mission training during this administrative year, and a huge thank you to the presenters to help make these events so successful. In addition to in-person mission trainings, we worked hard to connect our members to resources they could access from the comfort of their homes. Resources like webinars and our program engagement plans on the national website that provided guidelines and ideas to help members implement ALA programs in their local communities. Our junior members play a vital role in the auxiliary, and this year we made sure to recognize their accomplishments by offering the first ever Junior Members of the Year scholarship to 5 deserving recipients, one in each division. We also increased the number of Spirit of Youth scholarships. These scholarships are now offered one per department instead of just one per division. Scholarships are a great way to recognize the contributions of our juniors and to invest in the future of our Legion family. None of these expansions would have been possible without your generous contributions to the scholarship funds. And for that, I thank you sincerely. You truly supported our Legion family. It was such an honor to serve as your national president. I'm so grateful for all of our members. I may have served this organization in the top volunteer position, but it's the grassroots level that works the mission day in and day out to serve our veterans, military, and their families. My favorite moments this year have been connecting with you and putting our mission first. I will forever be thankful that you joined me in being the one to save one. I hope you to continue to always be there for our veterans, changing lives and saving lives. We will keep fighting until no veteran dies by suicide. Thank you to all of our national officers, our national committee chairs, and our national headquarters staff who have been alongside me this year. It was truly a team effort. And finally, thank you to my mom. You were supposed to be here as I reached this peak in my ALA membership, and while you may not physically be here, I felt your presence in every visit, in every hand I held, in every connection I made. Thank you for watching over me and for all the love. And to all our members, thank you for everything you've done to make this year special. I am so grateful. Let's keep building those connections because together, we can make a difference in the lives of our veterans, military, and their families. And please, continue to be the one.